everyone and welcome to Everyday Money Lesson. I am Shipra Singh and today we are going to talk about four cardinal rules of money management that everyone should follow to live a financially stable life. The very first and the most important rule to include in your financial plan is to spend less than you earn. The easy way to ensure this is to create a budget and check whether your expenses are in line with your income or not. Note down your fixed expenses like rent, commute, food and utility bills and non-essential expenses. Add them all up and deduct it from your income. If you get a negative number, you're spending more than you earn and it is time that you start cutting back on your expenses. This exercise is important because if you don't track how and where you're spending your money, it is easy to go broke even before the month ends. For credit card users, blowing away all their income is even easier as credit can create an illusion of higher affordability. Ideally, the leftover amount that you get after removing fixed expenses from your income is what you should spend and save. This gets us to our second rule that you should save at least 10% of your income each month. Saving regularly empowers us to spend on things without having to borrow and shelters us during emergencies. And yet, many of us postpone including saving in our budget as we give spending precedence over saving. That's not the correct approach. The right way is to save first and spend later. But how much should you save? Financial planners say that 10% is the bare minimum that should be stashed away at the start of the month before you start spending. You can either automate this in a liquid fund or start a recurring deposit or simply transfer it into a secondary savings account. After you have put away your savings and paid all your bills, the leftover amount is what you can utilize for aspirational spending. However, don't go overboard in spending by borrowing for your discretionary spends. Which brings us to our third rule, control your debt. Let's begin this by looking at data from RBI on household debt. Household debt of Indians has increased significantly between financial year 14 and 19, and the share of personal loans and credit card debt alone has more than doubled in this period. Easy availability of credit encourages spending and can easily push you into a debt trap if not used responsibly. You should try avoiding taking loans completely for discretionary spends. But if you do have to borrow, make sure that EMIs should not exceed 20% of your income. Also, when you take a loan, make it a priority to repay it before you take any more loans, as multiple loans affect your ability to build wealth in the long term. Now, to build wealth, investing is important, and this is our fourth rule. Saving helps us to create a safety net for emergency, but investing is essential to fulfilling future financial goals. Don't let your savings idle away in deposits or saving accounts, as inflation can eat into its value. Once you have accumulated a corpus for emergencies, start investing your savings in suitable financial instruments to grow that savings. Start by mapping out your goals. Depending on the time horizon of those goals and how much risk you can take with your investments, invest across a mix of financial products.